This is the project that we're going to be using to demonstrate intelligent objects. It's a car dealership, T-shaped plan, and on the right-hand side we've got a showroom and a couple of stories of staff and public accommodation, and on the left-hand side a high bay workshop. We need to make sure we've got a current layer to work on, so what we do is we just open the window editor. There's a layer already there that we can use, so if we double click to highlight that and select it and make it editable, you can use any layer names that you're familiar with. Intelligent objects will work on all of your current layers. They don't require any special characteristics or names. We can close that. And we then need to open up the properties window, which you can do from the keyboard with either Control and Q, or from the window menu with the properties entry. It starts off blank because we don't have an object set, but it will become populated with all of the properties that we need to set for our intelligent object. We're going to create our first intelligent object now, and the process is identical to that for creating a normal MicroGDS object. So we give the command object new. In the same way that you can use familiar layer names for creating layers, you can use familiar object names for creating objects, with one exception. The first facet must be defined in the intelligent object style that you wish to use. In this case, we're using a style that's issued with MicroGDS, so we have to add that to our object name. So if we select our external cavity wall as our object type, and then add a first facet, IFC wall standard case. It's this first facet that tells MicroGDS what properties apply to the object. Click on OK and then snap to position the hook point. And we see that the properties window begins to be populated with the parameters for the object. We have to define the style that we're going to use for the object, and in this case there are only two available at the moment, that's block and brick cavity block. We'll be using blocking when we do the internal partitions later on, so we select brick cavity block. And that sets the detail values, the default detail values for that construction. These values describe the dimensions of the material, in this case the thickness of the brickwork for example, the material that applies to the 3D solid, and the line style that applies in different views. So for example here we have the section line style. We're not going to be tweaking too many of these values during these demonstrations, but it's important that you know that this is where you would adjust them. The first section of wall that we're going to create is going to be around the top left hand corner of the showroom. So we'll zoom into that area so that we can see what we're doing. And to create the wall, we just use normal MicroGDS construction commands that you're already familiar with. You don't need to learn any new commands at all for intelligent objects. So we're going to use our trace command, and we're going to use 110mm offset. And we'll snap where the grid line crosses the edge of the slab as our start point, and on the corner of the slab, the internal corner with the workshop, and then because we want to return the cavity along the line of the workshop. We stop the wall there because it's a different construction for the workshop itself, it's a different height. And as soon as we press return, MicroGDS goes to the intelligent object properties and displays the appropriate graphics for the view that we're in. In this case it's a detailed plan view, so we've got a fully hatched cavity wall construction complete with the plaster work. We'll zoom into the bottom corner here, and what we need to do is we need to remove the stub of wall here that projects into the workshop area but retain the return on the cavity. So select the object and you'll see immediately that we have this yellow line highlighted down the center of the cavity. That's the baseline for the wall. It's the point from which all of the other graphics are generated, and any edits to that baseline are reflected in the wall construction itself. And you just use the normal MicroGDS editing commands, really simple, exactly again all the commands that you're familiar with, to adjust the line itself. So we're going to trim that line back, so we use the trim command, snap anywhere along the line, and then snap on the face of the wall itself. And we've got the cavity returning, but the wall itself finishes flush. We need to go look at the other end of the wall. In this case, we want to stop the wall short of the grid line so that the curtain wall in frame member that's centred on the grid line doesn't overlap the wall, and we need to pull it back by 34 mm. So we can use the vertex move command, snap on the line itself, and do R-34 forward slash return, and it immediately updates. Okay. If we switch to the perspective view, you'll immediately see that we've got the 3D solids created for the wall itself. That includes the plaster layer, so each layer of the construction is generated in 3D, if you zoom in close enough. But the height of the wall is not what we want. It's the default height in the system, and this particular wall we need to be 2 stories high. So all we need to do is just change the height by typing in a value here. So I'm going to put 7200 for millimeters, press return, and the wall immediately adjusts in height. Select that as an object, and if we zoom out, we need to create an identical wall on this side. So rather than go through the whole editing process, we can just use our normal mirror command, snap on the center grid line, hold the control key down, which tells MicroGDS to make a copy, and snap a little further along, and we've got the duplicate version of the wall on this side. Switch back to the detail view, and if we zoom in, you'll see that that return works just the same on the corner there. Select detail from the view style, and you'll see that it updates to show the hatching. And if we set GA from the view style, you'll see it's a much simpler solid line style. Okay, so we'll go back to using our detail view, and we'll be going on to create the wall for the workshop. For the workshop walls, we'll create a new object. Object new remembers the name we've used previously. Click on OK. So again, set the hook point and the object style. And as before, we just use the normal construction commands to create the wall line. I'll just leave a gap at the end there, and I'm just tracing around the edge of the slab. Press return to tell me I've finished. And again, we want to set this as an object and use our trim command to trim that line to the face of the brickwork. It's important to mention that this brickwork and blockwork display here is actually a line style. These are not real graphics, but you can now set the line styles to snap to the constituent graphics, which is what makes this possible. And repeat that at the top end, and again hopefully the cavities will line through to give us a logical construction. And if we zoom to the extent, we can see that's worked fine. We can now switch to our perspective view. Hopefully the perspective set, yes. And if we zoom in, we see that the wall is set again at the default height. So we change the height this time to something quite large, 12 metres would be fine, and the wall immediately springs up to the 12 metre height.